Hi everybody, this is the Whisper Corner, and in this video I'm going to look at 35 English idioms. Idioms are phrases or expressions where the meaning is not quite what you might think. So I have a list here that goes on down the page. And I'm just going to write the meaning of the phrase. So to begin with, we have when needs must. So what does it mean when needs must? And that is to do something you would have preferred not to. So you have to do it, but you'd really not. Like going to the dentist, I've got a sore tooth. Have to go to the dentist when needs must. Next up, is the Pope a Catholic? This is the response. To something. That is blatantly obvious. Is a public Catholic. Next up, to face the music. That is to be confronted. By the unpleasant consequences. Of your actions. So if you do something wrong and you get caught, well, you're going to have to face the music. Next up, like a dog with two tails. Well, you know how a dog loves chasing his tail? So if you were like a dog with two tails, you would be very excited about something. So it's like Kevin won £1,000 in the lottery. He's as hot, he's like a dog with two tails. He's going about like a dog with two tails. Next up, we have the elephant in the room. Let's try to save a bit more space. An accord. Or uncomfortable. Topic. Everyone is aware of. But no one wants to discuss. Like running out of space. So, if there's, say, a group of people in a room and there's something that everyone knows. knows, but they don't want to talk about that subject, would be the elephant in the room. Next up, we have to have your heart in your mouth. That is an expression or an idiom that means to be greatly alarmed or worried. So you're going about with your heart in your mouth. Next up is to handle with kid gloves. And that's to deal with someone or something gently or tactfully. So Kevin's a wee bit upset. Maybe you should handle him with kid gloves. Next up we have coming on leaps and bounds. That's where you are progressing rapidly. So say you start a YouTube channel, within a month you've got 1 million subscribers. You're coming on leaps and bounds. Next up we have meet your maker. That means to die or sort of like you want to meet God. So let's say, let's not mention my name, just got things. Jimmy has met his maker. Jimmy's died. Okay. Next up we have out of your mind. Out of your mind. That's to be crazy. Or insane. You see that cabin person? He's out of his mind. Next up, pay through the nose. Is to pay much more than a fair price. I took my car into the garage to be fixed and had to pay through the nose. Next up, a rough diamond. That's a person of fine qualities. But maybe lacks manners. Looking at you, Danny Dyer. Okay, the next one, the end of the world. It's a complete disaster. Or even to flip it around the other way, I was thinking, if we were to say, oh, well, it's not the end of the world, that means, you know, it's not as bad as you think. So, that's the end of the world. So it's a disaster. Next up, we come to a close shave. I've just had a close shave. That's a narrow escape from from danger. So it's a close shave. We have a narrow escape from danger. Next up is to throw a wobbly. That's to have a temper tantrum. Or to be panicked. Battery ran out on my camera and I threw a wobbly. Next up, to go down the wrong way. That's when you're eating something and the food enters the windpipe. Instead of the collet. So, say you're eating something, you get distracted, you end up starting coughing, and someone says, "What's wrong?" You say, "The food went down the wrong way." Next up, to sit on the fence. That's to avoid making a decision or a choice. Someone asks you what's better, Indian food or Chinese, you just go, "Eh." You're sitting on the fence. Next up, hold your horses. So if you're going to do something and someone said, "Hold your horses," that means, wait a moment. Or restrain your enthusiasm. So, you're running out to buy the latest Liverpool top, and your little bank balance in your brain would say, "Hold your horses." Next up, what do we have at sixes and sevens? That is in a state of disarray. Or total confusion. So that's if you're at sixes and sevens, you're all muddled and confused. Put the boot in. Put the boot in. That's to treat someone. Especially when they're vulnerable. So, say, little Johnny broke up with his girlfriend and then the next day he got fired. You could say his employer really put the boot in. Next up, to blow your own trumpet. Blow your own trumpet. That's to talk openly or boastfully. about your own accomplishments. So if you see someone that's bragging, going on and on about how great they are, and they're just blowing their own trumpet. Next up, rub salt into the wound. It's a bit like put the bit in. It's to make someone's bad experience even more painful. So that's to rub salt into the wounds. Next up is a little bit of a insult, kind of, and that is, the light is on but no one's at home. Or you could say, the lift doesn't go the whole way to the top. And that is to infer that someone, I don't really want to say stupid, so I'll go for what I said in the definition, mentally challenged. I'm sure we've all worked with someone who you could say, the light is on but no one is at home. Next up, to teach your granny how to suck eggs. To teach your grandmother how to suck eggs. And that is to try to show someone. Try to show a more experienced person how to do something. So, to teach your granny how to suck eggs. And finally, we have an armchair critic. Your basic YouTube commenter. A person who knows about a subject. Only by watching. Without first-hand experience. Our knowledge. Okay, so that's our list of 25 English idioms. So you have when needs must to do something you prefer not to. Is the Pope a Catholic? In response to something that's blatantly obvious. To face the music. To be confronted by the unpleasant consequences of your actions. Like a dog with two tails. To be very excited about something. the elephant in the room, an awkward or uncomfortable topic that everyone is aware of but no one wants to talk about. To handle kid gloves, to deal with someone or something gently or tactfully. Coming on leaps and bounds, progressing rapidly. To meet your maker, to die, to meet God. Out of your mind, to be crazy, insane. Pay through the nose, pay much more than a fair price. A rough diamond, a person of fine qualities but lacks manners. The end of the world, sometimes a complete disaster. A close shave, a narrow escape from danger. Through a wobbly, to have a temper tantrum or to be panicked. To go down the wrong way when food enters the windpipe instead of the gullet. To sit in the fence, to avoid making a decision or a choice. Hold your horses, wait a moment, restrain your enthusiasm. You're at sixes and sevens, you're in a state of disarray or total confusion. To put the boot in, to treat someone brutally, especially when they are vulnerable. Blow your own trumpet, to talk openly or boastfully about your own accomplishments. Rub salt into the wound to make someone's bad experience even more painful. The light is on but no one's at home, to infer that someone is mentally challenged. To teach your granny to suck eggs, try to show a more experienced person how to do something. And then finally, an armchair critic, a person who knows about a subject only by watching or reading about it without first-hand experience or knowledge. So, there we go. Thanks for watching and cheerio bye.